And now, please join me in welcoming back President and CEO of UnidosUS, Janet Murguía.
Today, I'm joining you from my hometown of Kansas City, Kansas. We're in the Argentine neighborhood where my brothers and sisters and I grew up. I'm standing in the Carnegie Library where, as a young girl, I often did my homework when I was in middle school and high school. Emerson Elementary, where I went to grade school, is right across the street. I'm here because one part of our conference theme this year is about reimagining our future. And this is where I, thanks to the hard work and dedication of my parents, imagined my future. My father worked at the Kansas City Structural Steel Plant just up the street at 24th and Strong Avenue while my mom took care of us seven kids. They instilled in us the belief that we could achieve anything we set our hearts to. Two humble people with little means worked hard, sacrificed much, and dedicated themselves to the education of their family, being good neighbors, and always offering a helping hand to those in need. They imagined a better future for their children. And of their seven kids, six finished their post-secondary education degrees. Four became lawyers. And two of them became the first brother and sister in the history of the United States to serve as federal judges. As for me, my proudest moment came when my parents paid me a visit when I worked in the West Wing of the White House. I'll never forget walking them down the hallway to the Oval Office so they could meet President Clinton. My mom, just outside the door, about to enter, had tears coming down her face. I could hear her ask and wonder, ¿Cómo llegamos hasta aquí? My father, he made a beeline for the president, stretching out his hand. I never saw him stand taller. He said, Mr. President, I want to thank you for giving my daughter this opportunity. The president put his hand on my dad's shoulder and he said, you know what, Mr. Murguía? I hired Janet and she may have walked you into this office, but you're the ones who got her here. I'm a witness to and in many ways evidence of my parents' belief in their American dream. This year, 2021, marks the beginning of a new decade and an opportunity for us to reimagine the future of our community. The last decade challenged us in every way possible, from the racial hatred unleashed by our last president to the onslaught of COVID-19. We have faced more than our fair share of hardship, but we should all acknowledge our community's role in battling the pandemic. A full 70% of our workers are considered essential. So when it mattered, we helped America stay strong during its darkest hour, and I could not be prouder of our contributions. As I look ahead to the coming decade and imagine the future of our community, I can't help but consider the fact that when given an equal opportunity, we've already been successful in every walk of American life. We can boast of Latino and Latina CEOs, lawyers, architects, scientists, astronauts, and engineers. We have Congressional Medal of Honor recipients, cabinet members, and members of Congress, and can even lay claim to a Supreme Court justice. And in the not-too-distant future, I expect we will see a Latino or a Latina president. We have made these contributions despite a history where our people have been persecuted and our freedoms curtailed, and from the start, our labor undervalued, our intelligence questioned, and our loyalty to country challenged. Just imagine what we could achieve if given an equal chance to succeed. How many of our Einsteins are lost to poor performing schools? How many of our Steve Jobs are derailed because our children don't have full access to health care? What if the keys to solving our climate crisis or curing cancer are lost because the American criminal justice system is biased against you if your skin is brown or black? We have shown throughout history that Latinos will more than pull our own weight if given half a chance. I recently saw a photograph of a young woman who graduated this year from the University of California, San Diego. She stood in the fields picking vegetables with her mother and her father, wearing her graduation cap and gown. Jennifer Rocha worked in those fields alongside her parents throughout high school and college. She went back in her cap and gown to honor her parents' sacrifice. She said, "I wouldn't have had the degree and the diploma if it wasn't for them. They sacrificed their backs, their sweat, their early mornings, late afternoons, working cold winters, hot summers, just to give me and my sisters an education." Her story is my story. It's all of our stories, and it's the story of our community. We are a people who understand hard work, sacrifice, and opportunity. We are a people who value family, education, service, and a chance to live the American dream. When I imagine our future, I envision a nation that sees our community the way I see our community, as a welcome and vital part of the American family. I believe that day will come, but until then, we are truly still an underutilized resource, not only for the future of the American economy, but its culture, its intellect, and its vision of a free and open society. We aren't asking for equal outcomes, but equal opportunity. Get the boot of systemic racism and inequality off our necks. Take off the restraints, remove the barriers and impediments. Give our people an even chance to compete and contribute, and we will do wonders. Give the undocumented a path to citizenship. Give our people access to healthcare and a decent education, and then just watch what we accomplish for America. We, of all people, understand the American dream. Imagine how successful our country will be if we all get the chance to live it.